All right. If you're using Google Sheets, sometimes you get the name error. So we're going to go through four different ways it can happen and how to fix it. And the first example of the name error, which is probably the most simple, is that if you just spell a function wrong, right? So let's go into B10. We're doing the COUNTIF function here. I'll delete the name of the function. So when you're typing in a function, there's a few things to take a look at. One is that you get this helper text, I call it, down at the bottom where it's telling you all the functions that start with C. And as you continue to type in, narrows it down. If you have a typo at this point, the list just goes away because there's nothing that's going to be spelled that way. And another thing to keep in mind is your formula is underlined in red if it doesn't know the name of the function. So let's continue misspelling this function. So I've already typed something in that is not going to work. If I hit enter, get the name error. And if you look at the text of the error, it says unknown function. It's another way of saying that you misspelled it because whatever you spelled isn't working. So any name error that you get, you really don't want to handle the error with an if error function and give some other type of message. You need to go in and fix the error. Name errors are caused by a problem with the actual syntax of the function, not what it's trying to look at or not any of the output. It's that the actual function itself can't work the way that it's input. So in this case, let's just go in and change the spelling. We know that's right and we hit enter. If you're not sure what function that you want to use, so not only can you not spell it right, you don't even know what it is, you could always use the insert menu and go down the function from here. The most common ones are going to be at the top, but then all of them are in this list. So you could just pick COUNTIF from here, I left clicked on it, and then you're ready to go. Just type in what you want. So if you want access to the spreadsheet that has all of the errors in it, and it has added notes to it, and even the error message that's not a specific type, so there's some information about that, follow the link in the description or the link that's on your screen right now, and you can get access to it. And if you go to File, Make a Copy, you can copy it into your Google Drive and reference it whenever you run into one of these errors. All right, so the second way in which you can get the name error, let me give a little bit of room here, is if you're missing quotes in your function. So I'm going to get rid of these examples right now and I'm going to type something fresh. We'll use a concatenate function. So we'll spell it right this time. And the concatenate function takes multiple strings and puts them together. So I'll show you what I mean by that. Let's do our favorite type of tree, oak. We'll do a space. And then concatenate needs a second value to append to that. So we're going to say tree. But if you'll notice, I'm putting these values in quotes because they're strings, they're not numbers. And so that's telling Sheets, use everything in that quote. And if I hit enter, that works. But if I do the same thing again, comma, and then I just type tree, Sheets doesn't know what tree means. You didn't surround it in quotes, and you can notice it's giving you a hint here, it's not green. If I were to put a quote before it, it's green until I finish, put a quote after it, parentheses, close it off, it's done. I forgot my space there, I'll put it in. But once you get rid of the quotes, it turns to black, you hit enter, and you get the name error. So that needs to be fixed. And if you look at what the error is telling you, it's saying unknown named range. So that'll give us a hint as we move to this next type of error. All right, so let's go down to the third one. Give it a little bit of room here again. And the third way in which you can have an error is that you're using a named range, but you misspelled it. So that's actually what Sheets thought was happening before. So if I were to just sum this and use a range, everything's right, fine, right? I'm summing B48 to B51. That works. But if you wanted to use a named range, so in this circumstance, you probably don't need it. But if you had, let's say, 20 tables and they each meant something different to you, you could use named ranges as your shortcut. So let's name this range. I highlighted it. Let's go to Data, Named Ranges. It pops up this dialog on the right-hand side. Let's name this range, let's stick with the theme. I'm going to be self-centered, Oak Tree. You'll notice I did not put any spaces in here. I just use an underscore. You can't put spaces in named ranges. Click done. I have one in here from earlier I was messing around with. So I have two named ranges, but oak tree is one we're going to use. And let's go back into this formula. You can replace that named range, or you can replace that range with oak tree. And you see I'm getting a suggestion below already about that named range. And if I left click on it, it selects that range. I press enter and it works. But what can happen is you just misspell it. So let's say oak tree, hit enter, and it breaks and gives you the name error. And it tells you it's an unknown named range. So that's what it thought was happening up here, unknown named range. But this was actually just supposed to be a text value and I forgot to put quotes around it. So let's go down to the last one. Last way that this can happen is you're just missing a colon in a range. So if I want to, let's say, average this. And I'll just type it in instead of using my keyboard, because that's, I guess, how you would make the mistake. B68, and I'll forget my colon. I'll try to go to B71. And right away, you see that the range is not highlighted in orange anymore. So you know it broke. B71, hit enter, and it doesn't work. And if I look at this error, it says unknown range name. So it's a similar error to before, but in this case, it's not looking for a named range. You just mistyped an existing range. So add the colon back into it. Everything looks good now. Hit enter and you're good to go. So the next thing that we're going to look at is how to make an interactive checklist using Google Sheets. It's kind of cool. You get to check off your tasks when you're done. I'll see you in that video.